The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The one who comes from above is above all. The one who is of the earth is earthly and speaks of earthly things. But the one who comes from heaven is above all. He testifies to what he has seen and heard, but no one accepts his testimony. Whoever does accept his testimony certifies that God is trustworthy, for the one whom God sent speaks the words of God. He does not ration his gift of the Spirit. The Father loves the Son and has given everything over to him. Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life, but whoever disobeys the Son will not see life, but the wrath of God remains upon him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
He is risen.
Hallelujah.
Good morning, brothers and sisters. Pakibati din ng good morning ang ating mga kasama. Magandang umaga po sa inyo lahat. Balik tayong trabaho. Tapos ng bakasyon, unless nag-leave kayo. And to our online parishioners, thank you also for being with us this morning. And we are in chapter 3 of the Gospel of John for the past how many days already. Binubuno po natin yung John chapter 3. At natatagalan tayo rito kasi ang hirap ho intindihin ng pinapaliwanag ni Jesus kay Nicodemo, lalo na nung una, nag-uusap sila tungkol sa to be born again, to be born from above. And this time, at the end of the chapter, of chapter 3, they go back to that theme. No longer in a conversation, but now, this is after Jesus met John the Baptist one more time. And now, Jesus goes back to that idea of the one who comes from above, who is above all. And in Greek, they have a beautiful term for this. The one who comes from above is anothen. Anothen is from above. So yung buong chapter po ng chapter 3 ng St. John, doon umiikot sa, what do you mean by from above? What does anothen mean at all? So this is the 12th mystery, panglabindalawang misteryo ng ating Easter mysteries, the one from above, anothen. What do you mean by being born from above? And what do you mean by the one who comes from above, who is above all? The one who is of the earth is earthly, but the one who comes from heaven is above all, anothen. We can speak of this in terms of physics, in terms of the material world. And in fact, many physicists and scientists are atheist, if not agnostic, because they have been studying the universe, they have been studying the different galaxies of the universe, at least the observable universe, and they're saying, at least there are around 200 billion galaxies. Imagine that, no? Our galaxy is Milky Way. The nearest to us is Andromeda. And lately, merong eclipse, no? Na hindi lang natin nakita. But in other parts of the world, there was a solar eclipse, total darkness. And everybody was looking up. So physicists, their job is to look up, to look beyond, to look at the galaxies. I have a favorite physicist, a very famous and popular one, a British physicist, Brian Cox. Ako po nung bata po ako, kung hindi ako naging pari, siguro ako ay naging physicist. Mahilig ako tumingin sa taas. And marami akong mga picture na oftentimes I am looking up, looking beyond. And like many young people, like many of the children, when we look up and when we look beyond, as far as our eyes can see, we are fascinated with the things of heaven. But we understand heaven and above and beyond in terms of the material. Sa mga grade schoolers, for example, ang sarap ipaliwanag sa kanila yung solar system, Neptune, Uranus, Jupiter, and the different moons that revolve or rotate around these planets, the different galaxies, how many light years away, how old is the universe. I was fascinated by this. I have been fascinated by all these topics about physics. Kaya lang nung napunta ako ng seminaryo, napunta yung usapin sa metaphysics. From the physical world to, so where does this all come from? Even Brian Cox, this famous physicist, would say, we cannot explain that. Science cannot explain the beginning of the universe. We can only go as far as some billions, 4.5 billion years ago, when everything started with a big bang. But that's far as we can go. We don't know how this started and everything started really. And so we have to look beyond. Ito po yung temang pinag-uusapan ni Jesus at ni Nicodemus sa chapter 3. What is the beyond? What is the above? Is it just something material that only the physicists with their high-powered telescopes can pursue and study? Ang sabi po ni Benedict XVI, the above, the beyond, is not a cosmological space. This is not geography. The beyond that Jesus talks about is a theological reality. In other words, God is not just one among the spaces or time. He is beyond all space and time. He is not just a space among spaces. He is not just time among time. He is beyond all this. Nakakaintindihan pa po ba tayo? Mas masarap po kausap ang mga bata pag ganito eh. Hindi ko lang alam sa inyo. Pero di ba dapat yan na rin ang pinag-iusapan natin, the beyond? Not just in terms of the physical, material world, but in terms of what's out there beyond. Pag medyo nakakaedad tayo, pinag-uusapan na natin yan eh. Kasi nalalapit na tayo sa dulo ng paglalakbay sa material world eh. So, what is beyond death? What is beyond sickness? And Jesus very clearly tells us today, there is someone above us all. And that's what the apostles were proclaiming again in the first reading, Acts chapter 5. They have been insistent. Ano, kausap nila ang Sanhedrin at ang mga high priest, kausap nila yung mga Hudyo, at ang sabi ng mga alagad, we cannot submit ourselves to men. We would rather obey God than men. And even that concept of God, who is God? Where is God? Can you find God up there? Kasi pag sinabi mong, oh, tumingala ka lang sa langit, o kaya just look at beyond, look at above, and tumingin ka sa Diyos kasi nandiyan ang Diyos, ang Diyos sa langit. Eh pumunta naman doon ang mga astronaut. Pumunta naman doon ang mga scientists. Pero wala naman sila nakita doon. Pumunta na sila sa Mars, pumunta na sila sa Moon. Pero wala naman sila nakita there, up there. In the beyond. In the above. And therefore, it's not a matter of cosmology. It is really more of a dimension of eternity. Do we really believe in that? That there is someone above all of us? That there is a God who has created and started all this motion and movement in the universe, that there is a beyond that we cannot fully understand except we take it in faith, that our life is not useless and senseless because eventually there is an above after this, that there is a continuation to this journey, not just limited to earthly. At yun ang sinasabi ni Jesus sa Ebanghelyo, what is earthly? The one who is of the earth speaks only of the earthly things. But the one who comes from above, anothen, talks about things we don't understand, but we really have to believe. Pakitanong nga ang katabi mo, naniniwala ka ba sa langit? Talaga? Not just as a cosmic space, or not just as a place up there, but really a dimension, a reality where we will be immersed in, because it's the reality of God, of the divine and the eternal. Lately po, may nakausap ako isang very successful businessman. Nag-bless po ako ng kanyang business sa BGC at nakapagkwentuhan kami ng konti at kung ano yung kanyang business model. Sabi niya, Father, ang dream ko sa negosyo ko at empleyado ko, lahat sila magkaroon ng bahay. I will provide housing for each one of them. Nagulat po ako kasi, wow. Bibigyan mo ng bahay lahat ng empleyado mo. Yes, Father, that's my dream. And that's the business model that I am pursuing. Sabi ko, bait-bait niyo naman, sir. Napakabait niyo para ibigay sa... Hindi, Father, kasi... Ano naman ang gagawin mo sa pera? Yayaman ka nga kung ikaw lang naman nakikinabang. So better share it with them. And I was shocked because sabi niya, yung mga nasa akin, Father, ng 15-20 years, binibigyan ko sila ng equity, ng share. Nagiging co-owner sila sa kumpanya ko. Ano was that? Nasisiraan yata ng bait ito. Ba't mo isa-share yung ownership ng negosyo mo? Eh, sa'yo yan. Pero sabi niya, no, Father, hanggang kailan ba naman tayo sa mundong ito? So at least sila, bago sila mag-retire, no, makuha nila yung retirement pay nila at co-owner sila ng kumpanya. All because he was telling me, para saan ba naman lahat ito kung pera lang? Why don't we make their life a little better, their family? Lahat ng mga empleyado niya, yung mga hindi talaga makapag-aral ng mga anak, sinasagot niya yung pag-aaral. Sabi ko, sana lahat ng negosyante kagaya niyo, sir. And that's why you are really blessed, because your idea of business is not just for profit. At talagang literal na sinusundan niyo yung what profit a man if he gains the whole world. He always looks beyond. And that's what our 12th mystery is about. The one from above, that life is not just material or physical, that there is an above, there is an anothen in our life. We'll have to look up all the time. Look beyond, look above, because that's where we came from and that's where we are going. Not a cosmic space up there, but a reality of the divine, of the eternal, which Jesus opened up for all of us. The one who comes from above is above all. Praise be Jesus Christ.
Now and forever.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who restored us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this Paschal sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this saving food, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalo sa ating banal na misa. To our visitors and pilgrims, thank you for being with us this morning. To our online parishioners, salamat din po sa pagdarasal kasama namin ngayong umaga. Our hands are earthly, but our eyes should always be looking up to eternity. Yan po yung binibigay ni Jesus sa atin sa araw na ito. He is from above, to open the door for all of us to the beyond, not just to this world. Ang buhay ng tao, hindi lang sa mundo. Binubuksan ng Diyos ang katotohanan ng buhay na walang hanggan. Doon, kasama niya. Ito yung dapat nating kapitan bilang mga Kristiyano. We believe in eternal life. We believe in the resurrection. We believe in the beyond that we cannot see, but in faith, Jesus tells us, He promised us, He will lead the way for us. Anothen. Anothen is the beyond, the above, and God opens it for us if we believe. After the Mass, we will have our healing prayer through the relics of Saint Ezekiel and Santa Maria Goretti. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may our loving God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.